Is California the gold mine for a real estate investor? The right answer might surprise you. Today, I'm revealing our top investment areas in the Golden State.
Hey, everybody. This is Ted Thomas, the Tax Lien Certificate and Tax Lien Authority. And today, he's going to be giving us advice on the best places to invest in California. Ted, let's get right into it. What are the best places to invest in California?
Well, there's a lot of good places to invest in California, so this is going to get a little overwhelming if I covered all of them. But in today's episode, I'm going to point out two counties very specifically that have hundreds of tax defaulted property. I want to say that again, hundreds of tax defaulted property. Okay, now I'm going to start by revealing that I made my home in California for more than 30 years, and I can confirm that it truly is a gold mine when you know how to extract the gold. But I should also mention that unfortunately for all of us that live there, the tax man also figured out that there's many eager investors that make money in California, and of course, they want their part of the money from those entrepreneurs. So today I'm going to be talking about San Bernardino County and Los Angeles County. Now, don't be surprised if the county treasurer in either of these counties posts an auction list with hundreds of properties. As a matter of fact, it could be thousands of tax defaulted property. Now, for sure, my students for decades have taken honorable and ethical advantage of these auctions, and viewers can expect these auctions are going to be held one or more times each year in each of these counties. So there's a lots of auctions going on in those two counties. Now, California itself is a huge state. Matter of fact, it's one of the largest economies in the world. Plus, over 40 million people live in the Golden State. Now, there's 58 counties. Tax defaulted auctions in small population counties will have smaller numbers than we're going to talk about today. But the large counties, they're going to have hundreds. And as I mentioned, in some cases, thousands of tax defaulted properties.
Well, let's start with San Bernardino. Why San Bernardino?
Well, this is a business of abundance, and San Bernardino County has abundance, let me tell you. Specifically, it's the biggest county in the United States. It's a huge landmass. It's so big that the sheriff has a fleet of airplanes to transport the deputies around that particular county. So the real estate investing in California is big, big, big business. San Bernardino County will auction tax defaulted properties, at least one online and another one offline each year. So the county is challenged by a revenue shortage. In other words, they don't have enough money coming in from tax defaulted property. So what do they do? Well, the supervisors take action and they tell the treasurer, look, you've got to get rid of those properties and get money coming in. It's the treasurer's job to make the auctions happen and get sales at those auctions. So they authorize the treasurer to actually reduce the amount of the starting bids at the auction. Now, most starting bids at auction are the back taxes. Keep in mind, in California, it can go 5 years before they put the property in default and actually auction it. So I tell you all that because the treasurer may reduce the starting bid price. It's not unusual. I've had it happen in many, many cases. All right, they can lower the price. The treasurer has power. I mean, more power than any other person in government. So we won't go into the government right now, but know these prices can go all the way down to $100 for a starting bid. Okay, so these are substantial discounts given right from the get-go, and people start the auction at $100 and it will go up. I didn't say you're gonna buy the property for $100, but understand starting bids could be as low as $100 in the state of California.
Now, you also mentioned the City of Angels, Los Angeles. So why is Los Angeles another one of your favorite areas in California?
Well, of course, Los Angeles City is right in the middle of Los Angeles County. Currently, the average home in Los Angeles City is around $700,000. So the auction takes place, and it takes place online, or if it's a live auction, it takes place out at the Pomona Fairgrounds. All right, it's not unusual to 2,000 attendees. It's not unusual to have over 1,000 properties with starting bids of just the back taxes. Los Angeles will auction property to registered bidders only. So the registration requires documentation and a minimum deposit of $5,000. No one enters the auction arena without the payment and the registration. The auction moves very quickly. As fast as you can snap your fingers, they'll sell a property. I mean, that's fast. This is no place for an amateur. They'll go there and watch, but you don't want to be bidding at that auction unless you really know what you're doing. They're going to really move some properties in the course of one day. The bidders must look at the properties ahead of time. If you haven't done your due diligence, you haven't looked at the property, you don't know the condition, you don't know the title, you do not want to bid at that auction. You need to do that all ahead of time. It's going to move very, very quickly. Now, annually, we actually conduct auction tours in Los Angeles. In other words, we take people there and go practice the auction because there's so many properties and there's so much going on. It's important that you understand what to do. There's definitely gold in California.
Are there any common misperceptions about investing in Los Angeles that you'd like to address right now?
Well, I said there's a lot of misconceptions from people, okay? Okay, it's first of all, people think they're gonna find affordable housing in California. I doubt if you're gonna find that. With the average price in the city of Los Angeles at $700,000, you can imagine properties are gonna be sold with starting bids of 10 and 20% at the auction, and some of those properties are gonna go out the door at $300,000 and $400,000. All right, so if you're an untrained or uneducated bidders, you need to figure out what you're gonna do ahead of time. All of these properties are sold at auction as is. Now, what is as is? That means caveat emptor. That means buyer beware. Listen, a lot of stuff can go wrong, not only at the auction, but with the property. They have earthquakes in California. They have an earthquake, I can tell you right now, it just destroys the foundation on those properties.
Well, what are the risks associated with investing in these areas, Ted?
I tell people, if you're gonna buy at the tax defaulted auction, you need to consider a lot of risks. There's earthquakes, there's wildfires, there's floods, there's concern about easements, there's concern about covenants, there's a lot of concerns. What is the condition of the property? What's the condition of the title? All properties are gonna be sold. Caveat emptor, buyer beware. Once you buy that property, I can assure you, if you buy it and you give that auctioneer money, they are not gonna do any refunds. Uneducated risk takers purchase real estate without researching property all the time. These are huge risks. These are costly mistakes. Bidders need to learn to be careful, making a tax defaulted auction a high-risk situation. Now, the terrain in Los Angeles and the terrain in San Bernardino County, both of those counties are very much the same. You can find grazing land there that could be coming up at auction. You can find desert land coming up for an auction. You can find subdivisions coming up for auction. You can find pieces of whole mountains coming up for auction. You can find dry lakes, flood zones, earthquake faults, driveways, streets, literally thousands of high-priced homes. They're all at the auction, all of them at the auction in both of those communities.
Well, do you have any particular success stories about people investing in these communities that you'd share with the viewers?
Well, it takes a while to get to know what's going on in each of these counties. And once you're an educated investor, there's plenty of ways to make money. Now, my students have done very well in Los Angeles County and San Bernardino County. But most buyers that are there are looking at housing, all right? So they only know housing, so that's all they've been on. So we have a policy when we teach people, don't just look at one thing, look at multiple things. For example, if you're a person that really wants a house, well, I appreciate that, but why not look at land? Why not look at grazing land? Why not look at crop land? Why not look at orchards and so on? So the savvy investors would notice right away when you look at the auction list that vacant land, about 20% of the auction list will be vacant land. So my experience reveals that there's less intense bidding on that vacant land. Now I say intense bidding, I'm talking about the prices going up. All right, so these residential vacant lots and vacant land, you'll find less bidding. That means the prices stay lower. Now you get a better chance to make money, okay? So buildable lots are something that are very saleable. So if you could buy buildable lots at auction, I have many students have purchased in Los Angeles County and San Bernardino County. They bought the property, there was no mortgage, there's no deed of trust, and they paid less than 20 cents on the dollar for the property. Well, that's pretty darn good. That leaves you the distance between the 20% and whatever the tax assessed value is. So it leaves you a lot of room if you know what you're doing, but you need to be an educated buyer. Both Los Angeles County and in San Bernardino County, land is abundant, If you understand water, that's called riparian rights. If you understand that, you understand power, you understand zoning, you understand land survey, you understand environmental hazards. If you know all that, well, you're going to be in much better shape. If you don't, buyer beware. You better know that before you buy, because what you buy may be worthless land, and you don't want to do that.
Hey, listen, if you have any questions for Ted yourself, just leave it in the comment sections below. You will get an answer to that. And Ted, I think you do have a free gift for these folks.
Right below me, they'll be surprised with a free gift.
Right there in the description column, folks. Thanks for watching.